begins with an L? Like the L word?
Lesbians. Ha!
I think our imagination...
Whoa!
Max
just got fucked up. What is going on, YouTube universe? This is ArghGodzirra. Today we are beginning an experience I have been dying to get my hands on. Pun intended. We are playing The Quarry from Supermassive Games. For those of you who are unfamiliar with Supermassive, you've only got to think of games like Until Dawn, Man of Medan, Little Hope, House of Ashes, the choose your own adventure style horror games where characters can either make it to the other side or die gruesome, horrible deaths. And I know that's what you guys are here for. And this right here is drenched in 80s horror already. The music, very reminiscent of films like Nightmare on Elm Street, Halloween. We've got the VHS tape on there, very reminiscent of Blair Witch. I can't wait to dive in. I hope you guys are keen to check this out as well. Oh, it's going to be so good. Let's get this one started. A Moonlit Night with David Arquette. Very peaceful. For now. Oh. I'm getting some Evil Dead. Speaking of Evil Dead, Ted Raimi. Getting Evil Dead vibes with the camera going through the woods like that. The opening chapters of Supermassive Games always hit hard, so I'm expecting this to deliver an incredibly powerful punch to kick things off. Brenda Song, has she even done anything since Sweet Life of Zack and Cody? I'm waiting for this evil spirit or whatever the hell's going through the woods here to knock this car right over. Here we go, June 24, Laura, Route 919.
Why'd you kill the music?
I think you know why.
I don't think I do.
Begins with an L? Like the L word?
Lesbians. Ha!
Lost, Max. We're lost.
We're in geographic flux.
Right, so... lost.
That's debatable.
Oh, heads up.
Oh, catch it.
Yeah, honey, nice catch.
Thank you. Man, the roads are definitely getting worse out here.
I guess it's all part of the rustic summer camp experience.
Oh, right, that's where we're going. I lost track like 200 miles ago.
200 miles ago, huh?
Yeah. You know what, Max? It's okay. It doesn't make you any less of a man.
You know, if Columbus hadn't gotten lost and landed on these golden shores, there would be no United States of America.
Really?
Hot dogs, see you later, apple pie.
Columbus never actually landed in North America.
What are you talking about?
Didn't even know he wasn't in Asia.
Are you serious?
Just another guy who didn't want to admit he was lost.
Well, just another guy who's got a whole day named after him, so put that in your pipe and smoke it.
Oh my god.
Yeah, smoke it.
Get us to camp already before I roll my eyes out of my head, please.
I'm working on it.
Sexual tension. Pick leaflet, pick map. Well, if we're lost, we're looking at a map, right?
What is that?
Yeah.
No, but seriously, how'd it happen to the normal map?
This is the normal path.
The one on the phone.
No bars.
Of course not.
Okay, let's see. So we are... Well, I guess they don't put summer camps on maps. Have you seen any signs for it?
Earth to Max.
Hey, eyes on the road.
Oh! Oh!
Max!
Okay. Because that's what we love to see. Oh, shit!
Stop the car!
Oh, shit! I fucked up the QTE. You all saw that creepy bitch sitting in the back seat, right?
Are you okay?
Yeah. I mean, still in one piece.
Jesus Christ, what do you think that was? A bear?
What?
The bear naked in the middle of the road, hunched over.
Bear,
yep.
What was it?
That was a human.
I think it was a person.
Lord, are you serious? Do you think we hit a person?
I don't know. I mean, it was really close, like really close, but maybe we didn't.
Let's just hide the body. Total deniability.
What is it?
I really effed this car up.
Well, maybe it looks worse than it is.
I should check out the damage before we try to start it up again, huh? Could you grab my the toolbox from the trunk?
Yeah, okay.
And boy, he's fucked the car up. I fucked the car up by missing the QTE because I pressed up instead of across. Like a noob. But it makes for a more interesting story, right? Yep. Let's have a Snoopy Snoop. He got rejected.
Max. Why didn't you tell me?
We could have let it be, but, I like to be thorough.
Do you need a hand?
Yeah, actually, if you could just shine a light right here.
Here you go.
Perfect, thank you.
The sooner we get out of here, the better.
Just picture yourself curling up in front of a big old fire pit singing campfire sing-alongs.
I don't think people curl up right in front of big old fire pits.
Why not?
They don't want to catch on fire.
And then picture yourself curling up in front of a big old space heater.
Well, anywhere's better than here.
Oh, you creepy bitch.
Where are you going?
Just over here.
Just stay there for a second, okay? I'm almost done.
Let's be compliant.
God, Max, hurry up!
I'm not walking off into the woods by myself.
What's going on?
I'm worried that there's somebody down there.
Are you serious?
Yeah, they could be hurt. I don't know.
I didn't think we actually hit anything.
Well, I don't know. I heard something, okay? Like a woman.
Do you think we hit her?
I just want to check it out.
Okay. All right. Just don't go too far, okay?
Be careful.
Yeah.
If we go, we go together.
Okay. Luck with the car.
Laura, I sure hope we make it out of this in one piece, baby. Fuck, it feels good playing a game like this again. Oh. Clue discovered. The Harem Scarum poster. This is a poster for a traveling sideshow. It looks like it's been here a while. Left forgotten in the woods. Are those burn marks around the edges? I've got no idea which way I should be going. I'm just wandering around hoping for the best. Oh, fuck. Piss off, bitch. You got to appreciate the fact that when you got headphones on, everything becomes infinitely creepier. Laura, if you see anything, we're running. Oh! Did you see that? That was really well done. Laura, are you okay?
Silence.
Don't be whispering in my ear, you creepy bitch. That was very subtle. They could have really packed a punch with that jump scare. I'm thankful I didn't. I'm not going on my head. No sirree, not today. And over we go, king of the QTEs. That's better.
Hey, what's wrong? Is everything alright?
Holy shit.
Talk to me, what's going on? What's
Silence!
Going
on?
There's something out there. There was noises all around me.
Honey, take a breath. It's okay. It's the woods. There's a lot of stuff out there. There's animals. It's easy to freak yourself out.
No. Can we just leave, please?
Yeah. Let's go. Yes, there we go. Purring like a kid.
Max, come on!
Here we go.
Meow?
Here we go.
Are you fucking kidding me? Max!
Okay, give me a minute.
We've got to go, Max!
Laura, you're not helping right now.
Can you just... I am trying to get us out of here!
Alright, enough! Shit, I'm sorry, honey. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
We're okay. We're safe in the car, really. We're gonna be okay.
Oh!
Oh, fuck! Oh my god, my heart just exploded.
Officer?
Roll it down.
Why is there a scratch on your neck, officer?
How are you doing this evening?
Are either of you injured?
Really, we're fine. We're just a little shaken up.
You folks want to tell me what happened here?
Yeah.
We swerved off.
Well, we were just driving, and it's really, really dark out here. And I don't know. We must have hit like a pothole or something, because. We swerved, and now here we are. I mean, these roads are really not in great shape.
Yeah.
I like that.
Sir?
The cop doesn't believe you.
Keep the car running.
Sir?
You're a bad liar, Laura.
Is this kind of like the all-time scariest cop?
I don't know. This is my first cop.
What, like ever?
Yeah, I'm not a criminal.
At least he's helping pull us out of the shit.
Now you folks want to tell me just what in the hell you are doing all the way out here this late at night?
Let's tell him the truth this time.
We're heading up to Hackett's Quarry summer camp. We're new counselors.
Do you believe me this
time?
We're
in early.
No, we know. But we figured we'd get in early and scope it out, you know? I mean, they know we're coming. We called ahead.
And to be honest, sir, one of us kind of oversold their navigation skills and got us completely lost.
Are you buying any of this, officer?
You're not going to make it to Hackett's Quarry. Not tonight. Harbinger Motel. It's the nearest place. You can bunk up there for the night, okay?
I think we're just gonna stick to the plan, sir. I mean, Mr. Hackett knows we're coming and we called ahead.
No, ma'am. You're gonna head to the Harbinger Motel. Do you understand?
Do we insist? I love that it's actually giving us time to answer and we don't have to pause the game. That is really well done. I'm curious to know why he's telling us to avoid, Hackett's Quarry, but because this is her first cop, I feel she's going to want to be a little bit more compliant. Don't roll your eyes at me.
Okay, fine. Yeah, we'll head to the motel. Understood. There's just one small problem.
I forgot to spring for the middle of nowhere coverage plan on my phone.
What he means is we're lost. Completely.
Directions, please, sir.
All right, ma'am. Step out of the vehicle.
Wait, what?
I just want to show you how to get to the motel on your map there. Okay?
I thought she was going to get arrested for a second then.
Remain in the vehicle.
This guy is sketchy as hell.
Okay.
If Texas Chainsaw Massacre taught me anything, it's never to fucking trust a cop.
Okay. So, we... are right about here. Harbinger Motel is here.
Right, okay, and where was Hackett's Quarry again?
Well, I'm sure the fine folks at the Harbinger Motel can guide you there first thing in the morning.
Right.
Okay, officer. Thank you.
Harbinger Motel. Stay on the road. Watch out for potholes.
Oh, you need like
a
statement?
Have a good night.
Sketchy as fuck.
Why is this guy just sitting there?
I'm not going to start a fight between the two of them.
That guy was giving me major weirdo vibes.
The dude needed like at least a dozen showers.
Oh my god, I know.
What was up with the thing? Did you see that?
Was it blood?
It was blood. That's what I asked.
Nice to meet you.
All right, let's get back on the road.
Yes.
I think I've had enough woodland encounters for one night. Thank you very much.
Agreed. So where's this motel?
Okay, so we're here,
mm-hmm.
and the motel is here.
Okay.
But we're going here.
What's there?
Hackett's quarry.
How'd you do that?
I don't know. I kind of tricked him into showing me.
Very slick. Are you sure we shouldn't just get to the motel and just listen to this guy's advice?
Honey, you really want to listen to the advice of some creep-ass cop who told us in the middle of the creep-ass woods to go to some creep-ass hotel?
No, that sounds terrible. Yeah. Let's hit the road, shall we?
That's what I thought.
Ma'am?
Oh my god! If he called me ma'am one more time, I was gonna shove that badge up his dick hole. Seriously, do I look like a ma'am to you? I got like 20 years before I'm a ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
What?
20's... debatable.
Easy.
I mean, I'm kind of into ma'ams.
Okay, we're done here.
Begs the question, was he trying to send them to this motel to throw them off course, or was he actually trying to stop them from getting to the quarry for a real reason? Laura Hackett's quarry summer camp.
You gotta be kidding me. There's nobody here. We drive all the way the fuck out
Max,
here.
Max, can we just look around before we jump to conclusions?
Did you actually even talk to Mr. Hackett, or did you just leave a message?
Well, what's the difference?
This is the difference.
There's a big difference.
Hello?
I guess he doesn't check his voicemail.
How was I supposed to know that? I mean, clearly there's somebody here.
Yeah, or it's just an abandoned car and this is a complete waste of
time. Why would there be an abandoned...
I'll be at the car.
Max, come on. Max, don't be a dick.
I'm sorry.
Don't be a dick, she says. There has to be a way in, right? So let's go investigating. Not that way. This cabin's definitely given me Until Dawn vibes. There's a light. The lights are on. Or is that the car's lights? I'm getting watched. Hello? Looks like I'm heading back to the car too then. Unless I'm going to have one more attempt at the door.
Is anybody home?
I don't think so. This over here. This is going to be a great map to explore, by the way.
Fun. What doesn't kill you will make you stronger.
Let's continue our hunt, shall we? But first, a quick word about today's sponsor. How funny would it be if I shaved a like button down there? That'd be hilarious. Oh, I didn't see there, sorry. I was having a little bit of a read. Today's video is proudly sponsored by Manscaped, the world's leader in down there grooming and creator of precision engineered tools for your family jewels. And speaking of tools, ladies and gentlemen, the Performance Package 4.0 is an absolute game changer. Just let me take some time to run through what you're going to get in that package. And I'm not talking about my package, I'm talking about the package. First off, ladies and gentlemen, the Lawnmower 4.0, the future of grooming, and dare I say, the best ball shaver ever. Now, boys, how many times have you tried to fix up down there and it's ended up like a scene straight out of a horror film? Never fear, the lawnmower is here. Their fourth generation trimmer features a cutting edge ceramic blade to reduce grooming accidents thanks to their advanced skin safe technology. It's waterproof and also has a 400K LED spotlight to help you get a more precise shave. And because this trimmer is waterproof, you can say goodbye to leaving a dirty mess on your bathroom floor. It even comes with a portable charger powered by USB cable so you can keep the motor running wherever you go. Now, mowing the garden is all fine and dandy, but if you want to maintain the garden a little bit better, sometimes you need to get in for those fine edges, and ladies and gentlemen, Manscaped have you covered with the Weed Whacker. The Weed Whacker is a nose and ear hair trimmer. It's waterproof and also provides proprietary skin-safe technology which helps reduce nicks, snags, and tugs in those delicate nose holes. Not only that, but their Crop Preserver Ball Deodorant and Crop Reviver Ball Toner will change the way you approach your hygiene routine. Now, Manscaped even threw in two free gifts to the Performance Package 4.0, the first of which is their Shed Travel Bag. And maybe the best of all, especially for myself and all the other plus-size men out there, the Manscaped Boxes. Whatever the occasion, it is time for you to start taking care of yourself. Head on over to manscaped.com and use the discount code ZERA when checking out for 20% off your order plus free international shipping. That's manscaped.com with the discount code ZERA, Z-I-R-R-A, for 20% off and free international shipping. Unlock your confidence and always use the right tools for the job with Manscaped. This looks ominous. What the fuck? Oh, no. Whatever was down there was what was on the road.
I'll be right back. I'm gonna get some help. Max! Max, get over here!
What's going on?
There's somebody in the bunker. I think they might be stuck.
Stuck? Is it Mr. Hackett?
I don't know. Just bring some tools.
They might want to hack something off.
Hey, I'm back. We're gonna get you out of there.
Hey.
Wait, what are these?
I don't know, you just said tools.
Why didn't you just bring... Look, there's someone in there.
I'm not seeing anyone.
What? No, look.
I'm looking, I am.
Let me see. There was definitely someone there.
There was 100% someone there.
Okay, so...
The hammer or the wrenches? Let's go with the hammer.
Hammer time.
You sure? It's gonna be super loud.
Oh, okay, so we wanna be sneaky McDeaky. Okay, let's go sneaky deek.
Yeah, okay. Wrenches.
Damn. You need a hand?
Yeah.
Whatever's down there spells danger, and I don't like it.
You've seen the Evil Dead, right?
I've seen the Evil Dead.
Hello?
Just don't be finding no Necronomicon and don't be reading out Klaatu Barada Nikto and we're fine.
Are you hurt?
Do you exist?
do you exist? Undermining his girlfriend. Oh. Hello, Ian. Is it just Rockstar Pool 69 joining us for a visit? Oh!
Max?
Is that a dog or a cat? Is it an animal? There was something back here, right? And of course, I can't check it out.
Hun, maybe it was a possum or something.
No, there was...
It weren't no fucking possum, mate. That'd be a big fucking possum.
It's been kind of a night, you know? Let's just get to the motel. We can come back here first thing in the morning. We can check everything out, but... I mean, you must be exhausted. I know I am. I think our imagination...
Whoa!
Max
just got fucked up. Oh, shit.
Max!
His blood. Help. I think I'm bleeding a lot.
No, we're gonna help him. She wouldn't leave her boyfriend behind. Even if it means she's gonna die here, she wouldn't leave her boyfriend behind. We have to follow that narrative. Turns out these two should have gone to the hotel like the police officer had suggested. I was just about to say he's gonna get dragged back down. Oh! Oh! Ho, ho, plot twist!
Does this look like the goddamn Harbinger Motel to you?
That is a way to kick things off. I said they deliver big punctures with their openings for these games, and that, man. The Quarry. You all I long for, all I worship and adore. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I don't know about you, but I think that's actually the perfect time to end the episode. So when we return, we either pick up again with Laura waking up from being drugged, or we pick up the action with the new counselors, and we have no idea what just transpired here at Hackett's Quarry. But whatever the case may be, that was superb. That was really well done. And I'm keen to see the angle that this game follows moving forward, because clearly whatever was down there is what was on the road that made them veer off. So the fact that it was locked down in that basement, though, makes me think that there's more than one of them. whatever they may be. It sounded like a beast kind of thing, so I don't know if it's like a werewolf or something like that. As a fan of werewolves, I would love for it to be. But whatever the case may be, I hope you guys enjoyed the first episode. Now that we've implemented changes on the channel, this is going to return on Monday after the weekend, and we're going to get 5 episodes a week of this bad boy until we finish it. So I'm keen to dedicate my time to playing through this and seeing what outcomes we can get. Let me know in the comment section down below if you want to see more than one playthrough of it as well, because we can do different decisions and have different outcomes and all that kind of thing. So if you guys want to see multiple playthroughs, you got to let me know in the comments down below. Do leave a like on the video if you enjoyed. Subscribe to the channel if you're new as well. But that's it from me, guys. I'm out of here. And as always, I will catch you guys next time.